Welcome to the third episode of Scrubbin' It Up with the Street Fighter V Beta. I apologize, I have not been doing Scrubbin' It Up every week like I thought I would, but that is changing right now. This will be going up theoretically every Thursday, unless something different comes up and I can't for some reason or other, but hopefully every Thursday this will be going up. It'll be Fighting Game Thursday. We'll have Thursday Throwback. We'll have Scrubbin' It Up go up on YouTube. It'll be a great time. But this is the second round of the Street Fighter V beta. Different slew of characters this time. You have... Let me just show you. You have Ken, Armika, Nikali, and Vega were the first four that it started with. And they added Rashid, and they will be adding Karin also, just as they added Birdie and Cammy in the last one.
Vega. I'll show you the epitome of-
and Rashid is really cool. He is definitely who I'm going to be maining when the game actually comes out for realsies. He reminds me a lot of Cody, because Cody's kind of frame-trappy, and so is Rashid. He's really cool. So, he has these spinny moves here by doing quarter turn forward and punch. He has these kicks by doing quarter turn back and kick. And he has these projectiles by doing quarter turn forward and kick. He can also, if he's dashing and you just push the punch button, he can do that dash that way. Well, he's got to be running. And same thing, he'll do the kick if you're running up. So that's cool, because if you're running, then you can just beat the shit out of him with that. Usually they don't expect that, at least not yet. His critical art is weird, because it's more an anti-air. So, like, you have to be right on them, or they have to be jumping over you, and you just take him into a tornado here like this. And then he has... His V skill is he, like, basically does a sick cross-up that you can do a dive kick out of. He can only do the dive kick if he's jumping forwards, which is weird. Like, if he just does a neutral jump, he can't do it. Which is odd. And then his V trigger is he basically puts out a tornado. I usually do it when I'm right on them, but if you're smart, you'll do it like this so that it like comes out and gives pressure. He also, I'm not gonna be able to show it off, I don't think, unless I can get him over here. I don't know what triggers it, but like he can jump off the wall in a really interesting way. And then like do dive kicks off the wall and that kind of shit, but I can't. There it is. Oh, you have to jump forwards immediately after you. Okay. That's weird. So yeah, this episode is going to be 30 minutes of me playing as Rashid. So if you don't want to watch me play as Rashid for 30 minutes, this is not the episode for you. I have been consistently winning, though. I think I've played 10 matches, and I won 8 of those, which is, like, a way better win rate than I normally have. Just, his name is JohnCena117. And the best part is you get to rename yourself. It's not necessarily your PSN name. So this guy chose to rename himself JohnCena117, which is insane.
Remember the name well. Come on.
I also like Ken in this. Not so much any of the other characters that they have for play. I'll definitely play as Karin when she comes out. Oh boy. That heavy Tatsu is what's up. I should be doing my V skill more often. But now that I said that, I'm gonna get bopped every time I try to do it, so I'm just gonna sweep over and over again, like a true pro.
Okay, 10 points, I did it!
Round 2. Fight!
But yeah, it's weird. I saw Rashid in the trailer and was like, I don't like his character design very much because he just looks like a generic person with a scouter. But I knew I was probably going to want to main him because he just, like, all of his moves are, like, very conducive to the way I play, where you can just be a total jackass and hit with them, which will, and probably does, annoy many players. But I can basically just, like, do whatever I want and usually at least take away half their health. I mean, unless they really know what they're doing. So that's good for my playstyle. It has proven very effective so far. It's weird because I wanted to record this on Thursday so I could put it up this previous Thursday, but I am now recording this on Friday, and I'll put it up this coming Thursday, or the Thursday you're seeing this, theoretically. And the matchmaking was broken. For some reason, people were only getting into, like, one match every, like, 2 hours or so. And I wasn't about, like, waiting around for myself to get in matches and then cutting the footage together, so I figured I would just wait, see if the matchmaking improved, and it did. Pretty drastically, in fact, like, to the point where I've been playing this for the past hour and I've gotten at least 10 matches, so it's pretty good. And I've seen a lot of people, I don't know, people complain about netcode a lot, especially in fighting games. And, like, I see so many people saying, like, oh my god, like, this game is unplayable and it's netcode. The last beta, I played a ton of matches, and so did my brother. And we probably only had one or two matches that were, like, actually unplayable. And in this beta, I have had every match just, like, work flawlessly. Like, realistically, no lag. I mean, like, I'm not doing any, like, high execution combos or anything, but, like, I don't really need to, I guess. So it's weird to see like that. Maybe I'm just not in tune enough to notice, but like the netcode in this game seems worlds better than it was in Street Fighter 4. So at least it's got that going on. I have actually yet to fight an Armika, but this guy seems to have fought a lot, so that's good.
Round 1. Fight!
Gotcha. I have no idea what the fuck to do against Armika. This is gonna go poorly, I have a feeling. How did... Do not let her do that. Oh! Yeah! That's what's good. No way should I have won that.
Round 2. Fight!
Usually that's what happens to me, is I choke right at the end there. She powers up when she does that, and that's a bummer. Oh, God. Oh, the butt. Am I gonna win with throws? Yo, second time in a row I won with that. That's insane.
You win.
No way I should have won that. That was actually scrub tactic share right there. I want to know what Rashid's deal is. I need to know what his plot is. Says he's a wandering hero there, which is a weird thing to say to someone. Man. I don't like Vega. I've never liked Vega. And in this, now that he's not a charge character anymore, it's like... I don't even know. He's like really fast. One of the two matches I lost so far was to a Vega, and I got beat pretty handily. Because, like, before it was like, okay, Vega jumps around like a crazy person, but he at least had to wait for the charge of the moves, whereas, like, now he does not. Okay, I did not realize you can push forwards to control that tornado, so it doesn't have to be, like, directly in front of them. It just helps. That was a pretty sick combo. But yeah, I feel like I need to use these spin-in moves more. I like this, this is his forward heavy kick. He just, like, does a flip. Here, let's make this less just me beating the shit out of a dummy. I actually have them fightable. So I can practice on Vega. In my experience, the CPU, the 8 CPU, is like pretty not good compared to what I would expect the highest level AI to be. I mean, like, obviously, now that I say that, he's gonna be beating the shit out of me regularly, but. Ooh! Okay, that was cool. And one thing that I haven't been doing in this beta is, like, I never use the EX versions of moves. Because I'm always too afraid that I'm gonna use them in the wrong situation and then just, like, totally burn meter for no reason. So... I don't do that. What the hell? Boy. He's not following up on that properly. I gotta stop doing that after I hit trying to grab, because it feels like every character can just follow up afterwards. That I should have been able to grab him out of. I don't know what the fuck that was. Alright, well, when I was fighting a level 8 Nikali, it was not rough. This is rough. But like I said, I'm just not good at fighting Vega in general, I feel like. And human players don't necessarily always go this ham as this guy's going. Oh, I fucked it up. I could use my critical art. All right, a real opponent. Let's go. This is gonna be weird. Okay, oh no, he's played a lot. Fuck.
Round one.
Fight.
Oh, I wanted to be able to flip over that so. What? His V-skill still activates even if you hit him out of it? That's fucking stupid. Are you shitting me? But mine doesn't. Oh my god, now I'm gonna lose in the corner here. Oh, that was all my fault. I had him.
That's what I was looking for.
Round two.
Okay, keep doing it then. He actually hit me with it. Holy fuck. Oh my god. That is awful. So angry. So angry.
Final round. Fight.
Ooh. Really? No way. I'm... Oh, God. I'm gonna lose. Man, I'm keep clutching this shit out. There's no way I should be winning these matches. Holy shit.
You win.
That was ridiculous. No way I should have won. Oh, man, that shit is so scary every time. Is this can't be real life. The fact that I've won 3 times out of 3 on this... Oh my god. Oh, I forgot I turned him on. Parries and stuff are insane. Like, every time I get parried by Ryu, it's like... God damn, I would freak out on the last beta. Vega's thing seems to be very similar. He's just like, oh shit, he just like totally took no damage from that attack there. That was real. Oh, come on, he even blocked well. One of my friends is going to play as Vega when this comes out, and I'm very afraid of that because the way he plays, it will probably suck a buttload to fight him. But then if you can do random critical arts like that and take away like a third of his health, that's really great. I should have been able to grab off that. That's some bullshit. Interesting. He should have. I don't know why that hit didn't block him. Oh, goddamn. I wonder. Okay, that does work. Okay, maybe I'll just do EX kicks. Because I'm not confident in my ability to do my critical art very often. Yeah, I've just never been a fan of Vega, so like when they announced Vega, I was just like, ugh, come on, man. It's cool though, because they'll add Karin to this beta, and I'll definitely do an episode of her, at least, if I don't do anyone else. And then I'm excited to see if they do another third beta, if they just have the rest of the characters. Because theoretically there should be 16 characters, so they could just do another beta with the remaining four? Yeah, remaining four. Which would be Zangief, the new character Laura, and two unannounced characters. One will be brand new and one will be returning. Which all the rumors seem to suggest, well, there's a list out there that's been totally true so far, even predicted Laura, who's a brand new character, and Rashid. And the two characters left on that list are Dalsin and a guy named Zen, so we will see. I would guess this, I think it'll have passed by the time this goes up, October 26th. Yeah, it will have. I believe that's Monday, is Paris Games Week, and I expect another character announcement there, but I don't know for sure. Capcom picks really weird places to announce. I guess usually it's in the country of origin for the character, because they announced Rashid in Dubai. So I don't know.
Round one. Fight.
This is the most laggy match I've had so far, and that's not even that bad. Jesus. What the fuck? What is... I don't even know what's going on right now. I gotta learn how to use that at better expression. Even if I had blocked, she would have killed me, so... That sucks. Man, I wanted to go undefeated. I still have the opportunity, I just don't think I'm going to. What? Alright, maybe don't do that. She seems too smart. Oh, and it makes him go faster? Yo, there's gotta be six setups of that then. Oh, it still hurt? Even though it. Huh. Oh my god, no. No! Oh my god! I was so close. Rashid's looking for his friend. I'm also interested for Street Fighter V to come out, mainly because the ridiculous statement that they're trying to have their story mode rival Mortal Kombat's, which, like, listen, I know that there's deep lore in Street Fighter if you're willing to look for it, if you're willing to read the comics. There has not been, like, an actual non-total bullshit story that you could actually follow in Street Fighter ever. And I don't know how they're just gonna be like, oh yeah, and now all these characters have personalities. I mean, I guess we'll fucking see, but I'm not confident that it's gonna be on par with Mortal Kombat story. It's no offense to Capcom or the Street Fighter team. When I saw that statement, that was literally, we're trying to rival Mortal Kombat story, I was just like, oh god. Don't say things like that.
Another fight is coming your way.
Alright, here we go. Last fight of the episode. Will I go 3-2 or will I go 4-1? I'm hoping for 4-1. I would like to win. I would always like to win. Because I like to win. Ooh, versus Nicali. I've had good luck against Nicali so far. So we'll see. US versus US.
Round one.
Oh, fight. God. You might know how to play. Oh, what? That wasn't an over. Oh. That's a thing? This fucker. Oh my god, bodied. I don't even know what I'm doing.
Round two. Fight.
Oh, he's got real combos. That one took away half my fucking health bar. Holy shit. Oh, and I got it's over. That makes me so sad. Well, that's what I get for thinking I was going to go undefeated. Get bopped twice in a row, except that time was something special. I got annihilated. Wow, he had a lot more points than me, too. Holy shit. That does it for episode 3 of Scrubbin' It Up with the Street Fighter V beta. I will be back again with at least one more episode, possibly two. I'm definitely going to do one on Karin, and I may do one on Ken. I do like Rashid, though. Let's come back for another Rashid episode. I don't know. But yeah, thank you guys for watching. I will see you next time. Peace out.